Hey, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the SmackDown Reaction and Results. I'm your host, Glenn Thomas, 1/4 of the Wrestling Marks of Excellence, which you can hear on Fox Sports Radio, 1340 AM and 96.9 FM each and every Thursday night. You can also go to iTunes and download it there. Also download on Google Play and Stitcher. You can go ahead and subscribe here on YouTube and also hit the bell notification so you never miss any of our updates, whether it's the Raw Reaction Show, whether it's the SmackDown Results and Reaction Show, whether it's just our podcast in general. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button and that bell notification. We start off here in Portland, Oregon. The SmackDown started off with Paige coming into the ring and explaining what was going to take place with Samoa Joe. Said that she called the police on last week before Samoa Joe even entered the house. The police arrived and arrested Samoa Joe for trespassing on AJ Styles' house. Nonetheless, AJ Styles mentioned and that the WWE was thinking about firing Samoa Joe, but AJ Styles dropped the charges and he wants the match to continue between him and Samoa Joe in Australia at the Super Showdown that she AJ Styles said he wants to handle it himself. So the match is still on, according to Paige, at the Super Showdown. Then we saw AJ Styles, who mentioned that, look, I'm not leaving my home until I know that Samoa Joe is in on his way to Australia. This is what I like about WWE, what I like about SmackDown here, that they show realism here, that it shows reality. No man is leaving his home when they know there's a stalker, there's an attacker outside who may attack his family. This is where WWE got it right in the storyline. Let AJ Styles be off TV this week. Let AJ Styles be at home this week with his family, and to make sure that Samoa Joe doesn't attack again, to make sure that his family, if you can see me, quote, marks is safe. So this is right here where WWE writers got it right, having AJ Styles at home. This storyline has developed tremendously because they took it outside of the ring, and they made it the vignettes outside at home. Makes this storyline even much more, as a wrestling fan, get invested into this storyline because it is outside of the home. Then we move on to the Fabulous Truth, who took on Cien Almas and Zelina Vega here. Very good match here, but nonetheless, the Fabulous Truth gets the win. R-Truth, whether you like him or hate him, is a former NWA champion. That's right, the same title that Cody Rhodes won at All In. R-Truth is a former NWA champion. Carmella with the hair change and the face turn is very good here. But nonetheless, Carmella picks up the win over Zelina Vega with the Code of Silence. And the Fabulous Truth gets the win. Then we move on to the New Day. New Day has a pancake recipe they try to give everybody. But the bar got tired of this situation. They got tired of the New Day acting like kids. So Cesaro and Sheamus comes out and attacks the New Day in the midst of flour and pancake mix all over the place. To set up their match here for Super Showdown, which takes place in Australia for the WWE SmackDown Tag Team Championships. The bar gets to one up on New Day here in this pancake recipe. And then he beats up Bootyworth as well. Move on. Randy Orton here. Ty Dillinger early in the show goes to the back and acts. Paige, the general manager Paige, look, I need a match with Randy Orton. He embarrassed me last week. That's not going to happen. I'm Ty Dillinger. Let's make this match happen. And Paige basically said, look, you're the number one contender because you beat Shinsuke Nakamura. He said, look, I'll deal with Shinsuke Nakamura later. I want Randy Orton now. Sometimes you better be careful what you ask for, Ty Dillinger. Ty Dillinger asked for Randy Orton. He got Randy Orton. And this sadistic Randy Orton, the same Randy Orton that we saw rip Jeff Hardy's ear, the same Randy Orton that we saw put a screwdriver into Jeff Hardy's ear during the Hell in a Cell match, is now the Randy Orton that took Ty Dillinger's finger and put it through a turnbuckle and bent it and pulled it and pinned it and pulled it and had Ty Dillinger screaming in agony and pain. This Randy Orton is sadistic. I'd like to see where Randy Orton goes from here. I mentioned on the last show that I want to see him in a title picture, but I don't care if Randy Orton ever is in another title picture again. Going around beating up young guys and being sadistic to each and every one of the WWE superstars on SmackDown is the Randy Orton that I like. This Viper right here is a star, and it's good for WWE to take Randy Orton and Randy Orton take it to another level. And then we moved on to what everybody wanted to see, One Night in Milwaukee, which, in my opinion, disappointed. Really much disappointed here in what was showed. I know the cliffhanger leaves more to desire, and the storyline has to develop a little bit, but we saw Aiden English come out and start citing things or historical facts about Milwaukee. Aiden English also shows a video of him in his room singing or practicing, getting prepared for the night show with no shirt on, and Lana comes in the room. Lana comes in and says, "English, I just always wanted to tell you, I wanted to tell you something, and I want you." And it cuts off, and Andy English said, "Look, TMZ and everybody else is buying, is asking him to sell this footage to him. Sell the footage." Now, nonetheless, look, we know this could be anything. I want you to take care of Rusev. I want you to do a good job out there. I want you to win. Actually, I want you to go buy one of my Lana Day shirts because Lana is the best. Lana's number one. It could be anything here. Clips off, cuts off. Rusev runs after Aiden English and is done. Guess we'll see next week what actually happens in Milwaukee. WWE giving us cliffhangers here. But we move on to Shelton Benjamin taking on Daniel Bryan. This match right here was a great match. This match right here was a match that why SmackDown, to me right now, is rolling high overall. Why SmackDown to me is the number one show other than Raw, because they put on matches that fans want to see. Every type of match is a quality type match. Their main events matter. But we saw Daniel Bryan taking on Shelton Benjamin. This match went back and forth between both competitors, where both competitors was getting the upper hand of one another until The Miz interfered in this match. Miz was on commentary talking about him and Daniel Bryan's match at the Super Showdown in Australia. Miz interferes in this match to distract Daniel Bryan. And yes, right, if you've been watching wrestling for a long time, you know what happens when someone interferes. Their opponent usually gets the win. And that's what happened here. Shelton Benjamin picks up the big win over Daniel Bryan. Shelton Benjamin gets the win there. The Miz calls Daniel Bryan yet another match. But it wasn't finished there. The Miz had not done all he needed to do to Daniel Bryan. The Miz attacks Daniel Bryan once again in the ring after Shelton Benjamin gets the win and puts the skull crushing finale on Daniel Bryan. This right here is a good feud again. Super Showdown, when it becomes the number one contender. Love to see. And it's so much intrigue and storyline here. Will The Miz become the number one contender? Will Daniel Bryan become the number one contender? Who will be the WWE champion after SmackDown? Will it be Samoa Joe? Will it be AJ Styles? Because you could see potentially Samoa Joe versus The Miz, or we could see Daniel Bryan versus AJ Styles, Daniel Bryan versus The Miz, Daniel Bryan versus Samoa Joe. It is so many storylines here that can take up out of this match. The Super Showdown is going to be very good here. Especially this match right here in the World WWE Championship match has implications for weeks to come on this. Not going to give you my prediction yet. We'll do that on our Super Showdown prediction show, which you also can catch on iTunes as well here on YouTube. Well, then we moved on to Becky Lynch. Becky Lynch comes out and sports a new Super Showdown poster where she depicts the picture of her beating up Charlotte Flair from last week, and when her standing on Charlotte Flair's back. Now, Charlotte Flair didn't take too light to this because she came down to the ring and attacked Becky Lynch. She gave Becky Lynch the spear and continued to beat Becky Lynch from pillar to post here, leaving Becky Lynch wondering what she was hit by. Becky was just hit by Charlotte Flair, but nonetheless, Charlotte Flair ends up standing over Becky Lynch as SmackDown get ready to go off. Charlotte Flair and Becky Lynch, just right here. Once again, feuds on SmackDown. The feuds on SmackDown mean something. The feuds on SmackDown are intense. The feud on SmackDown has some emotionalism. Have you invested? Has some realism in it. And has people wanted to get back. So this SmackDown, I give two thumbs up to SmackDown. SmackDown right here had me invested. Had me really wanting to go watch the Super Showdown and get up at 4 o'clock in the morning to watch Super Showdown live. Not to watch the tape. I know I can watch it on WWE Network anytime, but I want to watch it live. Let me know if you're going to watch the Super Showdown live. This match right here is very good. Becky Lynch versus Charlotte Flair. The storyline has developed tremendously, and Becky Lynch has turned into a good heel. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's the SmackDown Reaction Show. As always, yo, catch us on the Raw Reaction Show every Monday night. After Monday Night Raw, SmackDown Reaction Show after SmackDown every Tuesday night. Catch our podcast on Thursday as it drops. The Wrestling Marks of Excellence. Also, go to iTunes. Leave a 5-star review. Make sure you hit the subscribe button here on YouTube, as well as the bell notification. As I mentioned, never miss any of our shows again. As always, if you're not confirmed, consider yourself denied. End of story, ladies and gentlemen. Good night.